2, this is Star Citizen 3.2, this is the PTU, this is the H patch, I believe. I'm not even sure which letter of the alphabet we're on. Episode 79 for me. But don't let that fool you into thinking that I know what I'm doing, because I absolutely don't. So yeah, here we are, we're just kind of checking it out, jumping in. Is the Hobbity music itself, which I might have to deal with a little bit. Let's just bring it down slightly. Let's put it on there. Now we'll take the speech down. All good. Just trying to set the tone here so that we don't end up blasting ourselves. Anyway, we're in the purple zone. Chris is here, he's all flushed with excitement of his new release. The sands of Daymar are stirring. The dust of Yella is shifting. The silicate strata of Delamar. Subtly, tectonically moving against each other, causing friction, causing sparks to fly in the verse. As we jump in now, without further ado, we just bring ourselves into the verse, and we're just going to do a little bit of test flying around. You know, we've done a little bit of mining, that's all very nice. We're just going to jump in and we're going to see what different vehicles might be capable of. You know, we like to ask questions on the stream. We like to interrogate and prod the underbelly of the world, tickle the trout of meaning, see if it leaps clean out of the pool or sinks down into the fugitive depths beyond our reach. So what's the question? You know, I don't know, what can we say? Can you exchange a wedding ring for a toad? I mean, this is a good question. Can you exchange a wedding ring for a toad? Anyway, how many light switches does it take to change a man's mind? These questions and many others will be answered in this night's adventures. Hello, looks like we're jumping in. We're just waiting for the game to load. That's what we're doing. Just see if we get anything. Oh, hello, yes, we're in. We're in like Flynn, right, okay. So let's just welcome you now, Star Citizen 3.2. I think we'll take out the 600i. Now, for a minute there, I thought I was going to wake up at Grimmer's, but no, I'm here in my tight-fitting white snakeskin trousers, nonchalantly leaning my laptop against the wall, because, you know, I don't care, I'm a rich guy. You know, the extent of my wealth can be seen on a mere tap of my wristwatch. We can see that I'm 80,000 credits in the clear. Anyway, if I want a coat hangers, I can have as many coat hangers as I want. Gold-plated coat hangers. You know, there I am, looking down upon myself. I see myself returning in my own dreams like a crumpled pillow, thrown by a rainbow's whim against the tide of being, which is ontologically challenged by the virtuality of my own existence. As I look up, see the light that falls upon my skin is not the light of angels, but merely the light that shines out of Chris Roberts's own ring hole. Let's try and open the door and guess that we're in pod number 8. Coming out, we look around, we see that we're in pod number 12. We're wrong by 4, and that's a shameful amount of error for one man to bear. But between me and the next AI, that's right, you stand to attention when I walk past. That's right, it doesn't matter how bald you are at the back, how much alopecia you're suffering, and how much memory loss has caused you to forget to wear a vest underneath that jumper. You must be itching like crazy. But you were right to stand up when I come into the hallway. You were absolutely right to take a little stroll. And you were right to be using your data pad to analyse a crack in the wall. Very good. I shall carry on now. These AI guys, they know what's going on. There's always some fool stood in the middle of the terminal. Who's it? Who is it this time? What are you doing, son? Why are you up there? I like the cut of your jib, mate. That's looking very nice. Although I'm not quite sure about your trousers. Look at that. This guy's got all sorts of stuff going on. Now that's a look I've not seen before. Very nice. Almost like a sort of, I don't know, like I'm a celebrity, get me out of here sort of outfit. Got the khaki going on. He's ready to do some sort of underwater frogman's test where he has to eat camel testicles while Ant and Dec giggle like schoolgirls. Right, okay, let's never mind about that. Let's just look in here. I think what we might do is take a little bit of the old origin. What about this, eh? This is luxury now. I'm going to go for the luxury.
All of our landing areas are currently full. Please hold for assignment.
I'm holding for my assignment.
Unfortunately, our automated system is unable to access that ship at this time.
This sort of
we
thing.
We apologise for any inconvenience.
Do you think you could get
your
leg
try
down?
Try again later, or select a different ship.
Who is it that's stuck? Look at him, he can't get out. Poor guy, he's absolutely stuck, isn't he? He's stuck doing some sort of bizarre Robertsian yoga.
Oh, you lift your left leg forward and then you lift it onto the knee and you put it up and then you lift it on forward again and put your knee forward and lean forward. That's right, that's it. Swing your shoulders left to right. I do this every morning. Sandy makes me do it. Try and lose a bit of weight. All those pasties I've been eating. I love a pasty, mate. Anyway, keep going.
Oh, hello. I'm blocking an active flight lane and my ship's been delivered. I'm both behaving like a good citizen and in complete contravention of all kind of traffic organisation. Oh, B-O. Boo, boo, boo. Port Olisar, boo. Right, let's go. Let's go for the boo. 09, 09. No, we're this way, aren't we? 10, 00. Right, the 00. B00. Let's go. Let's get in the 600i. Let's get into the posh bathroom. Excuse me. Acid reflux in anticipation of the luxury mode. I've got a bit of a sore throat as it goes, but never mind. We won't let it stand in our way up the apples and pears. Look, as we see the beauty, the screaming elegance, the wonder that is breaking your legs. Whee! Look at this now. Why am I so... What's the word? Oh yeah, stupid. Why couldn't I go the correct route? Right, how do we get in? I don't even know how to get into this thing. I think it's underneath, isn't it? Unless I have an aneurysm before I get there. Right, look at this. Very nice legs you've got there. The 600i. Now, if I'm not mistaken, somewhere under here is the entrance of this wonderful ship. I think it's a bit further down. Something like this. This could be it. Here we go. Stand clear. That looks like a likely entrance way. Or maybe not. Right. Just bear with me. You know, the entire stream might be me just looking for the entrance. Right, okay. I'm not sure if anybody wants to comment on where the entrance might be, but you know, I'm not averse to a bit of advice. Look at this baby. Now, a lot of people have got a lot of a lot of things to say about the 600i. Excuse me. To be quite honest with you, it leaves me a little bit nonplussed. I'm not a huge fan of the luxury mode. I prefer the sort of Drake functionality over anything else. But I mean, you know, we'll see. We'll see how we go. If we can get into the bastard thing, we might see. Could it be here? Could there be a way into the ship? Could there be a way to access? I mean, just. Can't access the chat either. Alright, okay, fair enough. I don't know about you, but chat works for me sometimes, but not at other times. It's like it knows when I've got nothing to say, and I'm very grateful for that, because it's an indication I can always check if I've got anything valuable to say or not by just pressing F12, and if the chat doesn't come up, then I know I've got nothing worth saying. Right now, I can think of a few things to say about this, though. So I was quite surprised when I pressed F12 and there was no reaction, because I actually feel a verbosity sort of coming over me as I try to breach the whale-like exterior of this slab of luxury. I feel as if I'm trying to break into my own autopsy. Okay. Breaking into your own autopsy, is it possible? Could you do it? Could you fake your own death just to turn up at your own autopsy and go, ooh, didn't realise that my tubes were so clogged. What's he talking about? We don't even know. But mind that, your auntie's round. She's made a nice cup of Darjeeling tea. You don't drink tea. You don't, you know, but you like your auntie, so you don't say anything, do you? What am I doing here? Why can't I get into the ship? Is it that I'm not allowed in? Is that it? Why can't I get in it? Alright, let's try and get in from the top. Sometimes, I don't know, Roberts. Ooh, you're a slippery character, aren't you?
Yeah, I know. Make a luxury ship with no way in.
Right, anyway. Let's, I'm trying to be a little bit quiet because it's late here and not everybody appreciates you talking about the 600i at full volume. I mean, can I get in? I mean, it's a sleek looking thing, isn't it? But could I just get in it? That's the question. That's really not my cup of tea, I have to say, but we can always... I'm not sure what these things are that are sort of... Are those my feet I can see dangling over my ears? Must be all that yoga that I've been doing. Here I am, look, floating above the origin. What is the origin? I asked myself. How did it all begin? How did I find myself here? Aimlessly floating in a white jumpsuit. Who knows? Who knows indeed? Let's have a look at the weaponry while we're up here. Might be worth a look, eh? Look at this. Now that's a hefty looking beast. Is that a size 4? Size 3? I've got no idea. I don't care about such things. Not important, is it? Apparently, there's some other sizes here. Not quite sure what they are. Size 2, maybe. Size 3. Could be size 8. I'm a size 0, me. Just forget to eat. Right. Okay. Let me see if I can get in here. Why is it so difficult in the verse to do the simplest things? Let me into the and shit, right? I just want to get in. Is it too much to ask? Warning, don't stand here. Warning, there is no way into this ship. Maybe it's detected, actually, that I'm the sort of person who is really not welcome in this kind of environment. It's like a self, sort of like a class detection system. I'm afraid you'll have no class. You really, really, I would like you to turn around and go the other way. All right, let's... Oh, it's slightly irritating that there's no yellow marker on that, but now we've found a way in. It's all well and good, isn't it? That could have killed me dead. So this is where you would bring your rover in, presumably. I'm assuming there'd be some sort of panel here. Yes. Here we go. This is all very nice, very sleekly done. Look at that. It's beautiful, isn't it? Look at that. All right, people, we're in. We made it inside. Can we access some of this stuff? Right, so I'm assuming there's some panels here that, yeah, engineering panel. Okay, so that'll be something that we can tool around with. But yeah, I don't mind it actually. This kind of utility section. Yeah, okay. It's a nice rendition of the multi-dimensional E8 there. Just to remind you that we're all just fibers of a multi-dimensional object that we can't understand. And these are some of the luxurious surfaces that we can expect. In our lack of understanding, we've turned away from the multi-dimensional reality that creates our existence and focused instead on just larging it up in a luxurious Apple Mac spaceship ready to party with our rover. Right, let's see what's this way. Oh, this could be, it's a shower. No, it's a lift. What's through here? Oh, look at this now. Now, I have a feeling that this is the captain's bedroom. Let's see what the captain's been reading, shall we? Compilers, the ubiquitous Logan L. James. Programmer's Guide to Odysseus? No. To Programmer's Guide to what? To something systems. I can't quite read that. I'm not quite sure what that is. But, you know, if it had been a programmer's guide to James Joyce's Ulysses, now that would be something. Now, this is the best bed in the verse, I'm assuming. Nice view. I think if I woke up to that view, I think I would really feel like I'd lost my mind. And the fact that the sheets are made of some kind of rubberized material. I'm not sure. It's a bit like a bedwetter's palace, isn't it? It's like you admit that you leak urine during the night, but you're going to do it in style. You know, if I'm going to wet the bed, I'm going to do it with a view of the stars. We're all of us in the gutter, but some of us are looking at the stars. Right, okay, let's go and check out the plants. No? There's no seven-pointed flowers in there, is there? That's a shame. Never mind. Nice bit of veneer. Lovely. Does look slightly odd to see that, doesn't it? You just assume that that's not real wood. But of course it would be in a verse like this. Oh, the captain's made some notes. Here he is. Look, he's going to have a cigar and he tried to sit down and write down his thoughts. No, he couldn't think of anything to write. It's all so luxurious, it's so clean and pristine that there's really just nothing left to say. Okay, let's just have a little look in here, shall we? Going to jump in to the elevator and take ourselves to the let's go to the top deck. This is the origin, my friends. This is how it is. It's kind of nondescript. That's the place we want to go. We'll go there in a minute. Look at these escape pods, in case you can't take it anymore. The luxury is too much for you. You can set the controls for the heart of the sun, or you can You can press the slummit button, and that will take you immediately to Grim Hex. Deposit you where there is no luxury whatsoever. Oh, look at this now. This is rather nice. You can stare at the blue orb. This is the Explorer version, I believe, so you would come in here to sort of, like, you know, you would have scan the world that you're visiting. Can I get through here? Oh yeah, there we go. You can scan the world. There's a really serious case of you can imagine all the people who work on these ships have all got sort of bandaged foreheads where they've walked straight into a glass panel that they didn't know was there. Oh, I can see you fly 600i, mate. You've got a big egg on your forehead. Right, this is one of the scanning panels. So, I don't really want to enter it because I've heard they're a bit buggy, so we won't do that right now. But it is, you know, I went to the Apple Mac store the other day and, yeah, it was a bit like this. Right, let's have a look out here. That's the lift where we came in. Let's just nip up here. Through here is some sort of, yeah, this is the observation deck and the sort of bar area where you might chill out, think to yourself, where am I? Oh, in a minute, it will tell me. I'm at Ollie something. It will come round again in a minute, love, don't worry. Look at that lovely marble there. Arcturian marble. From the planet Arcturian 5. Which is on the far reaches of the Outer Caliban system, or some such bollocks that they made up. Here's a fine selection of drinks here. Let's just get down and dirty here with the drinks. We've got some Sky. Reach out and steal yourself a piece of Sky. In the words of the eight-legged groove machine, like the most premium. Obviously, there's the Radagast. Oh. I do believe we have an imposter aboard. Maybe I should just get moving. And this is just some sort of cargo area which we don't need to worry about. Let's just nip down here. Scoot through here. Oh no, this was the scanning station, wasn't it? Now do we need to come through here? No. Nice to figure out where a man might go. I don't want to go in there, and I don't want to go to the bar. I want to head aft. Heading aft, we shall find ourselves in the place to be. Look at this. Alright, where's the captain's chair? Can't even read that, mate. Come on, Roberts, don't mess me about. Enter the seat. Enter the pilot's seat? Is this gonna do it? Is this really what it's come to? Is it flyable in the game? That's what we want to know. Is this even the pilot seat, or is this some other? This is some remote seat, isn't it? All right, let's get out of here because that's where we want to be, of course. Okay, but how do we get in? Oh, this might be a bit of a bug fest, people. Let's see if we can get in here. I mean, I'm quite happy to do the flight ready button. But how do I get in? Is it that it's not flyable? Is that the thing? Oh, I was hoping to take it out for a spin. Oh, here we go. Enter pilot seat. There we go. Alright, that was quick. He's in. He's in. Oh, yes. Very nice. Very nice. Right, let's see what we can see here. Flight ready.
Origin jump works at your service. Your system operational.
Beautiful. Right. Okay, peeps. We're off. A little jaunt in the luxury. Feel the power. Right, okay. Yeah, that's not too bad. Not too bad at all. Let's ease it out now. Ease it out.
Warning, your ship is becoming an active flight bay.
Don't give me that, alright? Don't give me any of that.
Initiating ship storage procedure. For your safety, please vacate the area. Thank you for your cooperation.
I'm vacating the area, mate. Don't worry about that. There she goes, look at that. Leaving behind a vaporous trail of expensive farts. Beautiful, alright, let's have a look at the old... Let's have a look at the old bathtub as it flies elegantly away. It is very yacht-like, isn't it? Look at that captain's bed there. Wet the bed in style with the 600i. Look at that. It's amazing. He's flying the ship just thinking, oh, I wish I was in bed. That's fantastic. That is absolutely fantastic. I like that rainbow sheen on the nose there. That's very, very nice. Alright, but yeah, I'm liking this. This is alright. Let's just see what the top speed is, shall we? As we rocket up. See the engines humming. I like the display, that's very nice. Not sure how practical it is. This is very nice. Very nice indeed. I don't know if I can be bothered to wait for it to get to top speed, so we'll just imagine that the top speed is around the usual sort of constellation sort of a speed. Alright, let's do a little bit of spooling, shall we? There's no spool like the old spool. Who's more spoolish? The spool or the spool who follows him? Oh, got a little bit of a crime stat rating there for parking violation. Naughty. Very naughty. Right, let's see what we can do here. Can I actually align to the comm array? Let's do that. Yeah. Let's see what she looks like in the old quantum moment. Difficult to see with the old quantum, but something that they need to fix is the angle of the dangle on the visual spangle. It's not so easy to handle, is it? If you get my drift, if you catch my meaning, if you lick my flagpole, you might be quite surprised how sweet it is. Right, let's just see what we can do here. What is he talking about? Flagpoles? What's he on about? Oh, look at this. Bedwetter's paradise. Look at it. It's amazing. Incredible. The sleek hotel bathroom. Now, that's something else, that, isn't it? I'm sorry, my big fat head's in the way. Let's just make it a little bit more clear for you people. There we go. Incredible stuff. Let's come in a little bit closer, shall we? Let's see all that seats glitching in and out. Let's see what we can see here. Look at him go. One man. And his Triton shower. Off to explore the universe. It's too sleek for me. It's just too sleek. It's just lots of space and too many pool tables. I didn't see the pool table actually. I'm not sure if it's in the bar or somewhere else. Or maybe it was just a dream. A spaceship with a pool table in it. you can imagine all sorts of problems with the gravity in that scenario. Anyway, fancy a game of killer, anyone? Imagine the arguments. Right, okay. I'm sort of hoping that I can zoom in on some of these characters here. Spooling away. Cryastro. Nope. Don't want Cryastro. What's this fella here? Sell-in. No, not so much of a sell-in as a sell-out. I'd forgotten the whole planet then. I'd forgotten. I haven't been to sell-in for so long. I feel like I want to go to Daymar. Let's just have a look here. Can I set as destination? Not while I'm suffering this infernal bleeping noise, I can't. Maybe we'll just do it like this. Let's just try that again, shall we? Yellow. There we go. Daymar. Doesn't want to know. Doesn't want to know, does it? Why is that, though? Why can't I select Daymar? Okay. I don't mind. We'll go to sell in instead. Not so much of a sell in as a sell out. Let's go there. Calibrating. We've calibrated. Let's go. Just recalibrate, yeah. I don't mind a bit of a spool. I don't mind. Going back to spool. Look at this. Not much of a view, is it? Here he is, look, he's pleased with himself. Oh dear. That's not so good. Real trouble. Come on now. Hand reaching. Oh, death in the 600 eye. A terrible turn up for the books. Murdered in my own bathroom by a bunch of rabid vagabonds. Did you see how easily they stripped off the armor off that thing? My god. Talk about a damaged state. That's ruined my night out. There I was, getting ready to wet the bed. They stripped me of my armour, sent me floating off into the inky blackness to suck on the vacuum of my own demise, my hand reaching poetically into the stars as my ship exploded beneath me. The fine bathroom, torn to shreds by its own velocity, its sleek lines rendered into screaming metal by the ballistic ferocity of the attack. Alright, now you know. Never get a space in your own bathroom. Leave your bathroom at home and head out there in something that's a bit more tooled up. Otherwise you will just end up wet in the bed. Right, okay. On that note, I shall bid you fare thee well. but I mean, I hope you enjoyed the little tour of the 600i. You can see how easily it might be torn to pieces by those of a piratical sensibility. You know, never leave home without a team of trained cleaners who might be persuaded to man the turrets, to leave the bleach and the J-cloths. Seems like the verse is out to get me tonight. On that note, the gunshots flying around the cubicle, I shall bid you good night. Thanks for watching. Oh my god. A flying bathroom, that's absolutely unbelievable, isn't it?